night, morning all. Well, I left this last night and back to it this morning, and I'm just trying to locating the new, because I'm putting a pair of valves on the U-bolter, are going to be longer, so these are the ones for the parabolics. And what I'm going to do is going to try and pinch this up on this side, because I can't locate the axle on the pin the other side, because every time I locate this side that pops off, and vice versa, trying to get that on this pops off. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to gently secure that so it doesn't move too much, and then hopefully with a bit of levering and pushing and pulling I'll get that one over there. What's holding it is the prop shaft, the angle of the prop shaft, and it is on a little bit of a spline that pulls in and out for some unknown reason. Either it's not coming out properly, or I can't just get it right. And it is always awkward with a vehicle with you know, chocolate stands. So they're not the best, but you know, they are rated, but I'm still not happy. And the one over the far side is on to the full extent. I usually have a piece of wood, but I haven't got my piece of wood here. It's under the other one. I've got my jack, which is at the ready, just in case. It takes a bit of weight there. The little chocolate jack is underneath there, holding the diff. So I'm going to pinch these up and hopefully just secure them, as you can see, just to secure it in position approximately. Approximately is the right word here. It is on its pin, even though it's a slight twist, but then I need to pull the axle. So it's just a question of so it doesn't pop off. Hope that's clear. Then hopefully it should be okay. I'm a bit concerned about the flexi pipes. They haven't been extended, but they didn't get extended on the back. But once the weight's back up, I can't see a major problem. But if there is, I'll have to extend the pipes or something, whatever. But anyway, I'll cross that bridge when I come to it, because at the moment it's there's no weight. Anyway, oops, catch you on a bit. Cheers. Right, what I've done, I'm still having a problem trying to locate this side of the U-bolt and the pin. As you can see, that is quite a little bit of movement left in that. It's not tight at all whatsoever. So what I did is I dropped the front pin out of there, as you can see, located the pin on here, put the U-bolts on, just pinch tight again so they don't come undone. And what I'm going to do is now is I'm going to try and pull and shove and squeeze to try and get that on there. So at least I can put a small pin in there to locate the hole and just tap the bolt through, and I think that might be the easiest solution. At least I have some leeway now that this isn't going to come loose, and then there's some travel on there, because you know they will travel further forward, the shackles, and they are loose. I might have to just pinch them tight a bit just so it's not too loose, but and then hopefully then get them squared up, and then I'll re-square up the U-bolts so they're sitting right. But nothing's going to be ever tightened up too much, because you are supposed to keep it tight and then go on a little jig along, you know, jig around a bit, go for a little ride. Well, I've got speed bumps up the road, so if I bung up the speed bumps for 30 miles an hour in the next hour or two when I get it finished, it'll check it out. I've still got to put the shock absorbers on, but hey ho, still got a bit to do on the springs. So yeah, coming along, and then get on. Oops. I'll get on to the lighting problems I have. So that's how I'm trying to get around it anyway. There could be easier ways. I suppose I could disconnect the prop shaft, but I'm just trying to avoid as little as I can. That's not too far out, and as you say, at least I can pull that forward off the spring shackle, even if I get a little ratchet strap and pull forward, and then just put a bar in there just to hold it down. So I'm sure I'll get around that a lot easier than trying to locate that pin, because I've just hubbed and puffed and I couldn't get it on. No way, not in this earth. Anyway, cheers folks. Well, that wasn't easy. Right, I had to put the strap round and pull it and jiggle it and wiggle it, and eventually got that front pin back in. I've gently tightened up the U-bolts and tapped them just to make sure they're squared and sitting and right. I'm just going to now put the nuts on the end of that, tighten up and just go around and just pinch tight. I'm just going to check the axle oils, swivel oils, etc. I've got to put the shockers on, but I'll hang on to the shock. Well, I'll put the shockers on, but yes, you know, so I'm just doing the oils now. Self-explanatory, there's little plugs of course in the bottom. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pull the plugs out and drain them all out, and then re-top up with the fresh oils. they don't seem to be leaking, which is the classic. If they don't seem to be leaking, they've got no oil. But we'll see. I'll see about the diff as well. I've done the back when I did the back section. It's a bit of a struggle that was, but anyway, cheers. Made a little fill bottle, a bit of plastic tube I had to fill up swivels, etc. So a little plastic bottle, crushed it a few times, or I was to do the diff as well. Never popped out because it's a nice squeezy fit. But as you say, improvise and see how we go from there. Shocker's on, I've just got to put a band around the bottom there, jack it up now, put the wheels on, and go and take it for a spin after washing my hands, of course, and beating my trousers clean because I don't want to sit on my nice clean seats. So we'll come back and report anything. But I have got a water leak, so I can't go far because that thing, heater control valve I've ordered, should be here tomorrow, next day. So I'll get that changed out tomorrow or the next day when it comes, but I've still got the wiring to do and a few other little jobs keep on top. And there'll be front wheels balancing as well, just to recheck them. A little bit of wobble at 50, 55. Anyway, cheers. Well, it makes it even blooming higher off the ground. But I just took it round all the speed bumps around where I live. Not too mad like, but gently. I haven't been underneath at the moment, I'm stuck in a humbug. So, seemed to go alright. Didn't oscillate as much. Didn't make such a much a clunk. You know, with the big old car springs. It seemed to bounce a little bit better. And the oscillations didn't seem to send me through to next week. So, yeah. Quite a large front area. I'm still going to put a stud on. I haven't put my locking stud on, but I'll do that. I've just got to go underneath now and check, but I'm having a shower now, it's light. I've got to put dinner on. There you go. There it is. Lovely sticker. Built by Land Rover, improved by me. Thank you very much. That person who gave it me, Kareem. Cheers. All the best. There you go. Water's leaking out, I can see it dripping underneath there. So, yes, waiting for that now. Cheers.